Hi, welcome to ElectroBuff. Today I'll show you how you can make a transformer power supply with just a few components. It's based on the capacitor C1. The value is 0.7 microfarads and it's rated at least 400 volts. Ensure it's non-polarized. So what happens is that capacitors allow alternating current to flow through them, but not direct current. So there's a small fuse and a current limiting resistor FR1 as well as another resistor R1. So the capacitor C1 basically acts as a voltage dropper, and the voltage across this node and this node will be dependent on the value of the capacitor C1 and the frequency, as also the output current will be dependent on the capacitor C1. So here you have two Zener diodes which maintain the voltage being fed to the bridge rectifier at 16 volts. So when the output here is more than 16 volts, this Zener diode will conduct and shunt extra voltage. When the signal reverses more than 16 volts here, it will cause this Zener diode to conduct and the excess voltage will be shunted across the mains windings. So the Zener diode should be rated at least 3 watts. So here you have your raw voltage AC signal which is fed to the full bridge rectifier. You can, for the diodes, you can use the 1N4007 if you have 4 of those, or if you have one full bridge rectifier in a single package, you can use that one. So what happens, the AC goes across these two terminals, and here you have your DC positive and here you have your DC negative. So at the output you have a final Zener diode of 12 volts. If you want 5 volts, you can use 5 volts Zener diodes, and it should be rated at least 3 watts. And you have a storing capacitor to keep the voltage steady. You also have a current limiting resistor to protect the Zener diode from being blown out by any excess current flowing through it. So this is a small power supply with an output current of about 100 milliamps. It can be used as an auxiliary power supply for a switch mode power supply, or as a power supply for LEDs, a few of LEDs, or just as a power supply for any raw current projects. So with that being said, this marks the end of my video. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe to my channel for more amazing tutorials and projects, and also click the notifications bell to get updated immediately when I upload new videos. I wish you a nice time.